June of 1862. Now, as McClellan has been hanging out outside of Richmond, finally they attack and they interact against the rebels in what is known as the 7 Days Battle. Now, Robert E. Lee, who is the best known, probably Confederate general, but has not been talked about yet, so he needs to be added to your list, faced off against General McClellan. Now, Jeb Stuart was also there, and he performed this daring tactic of going around, taking 1,200 men, and trying to figure out the Union positions. He came back super successful on this. He only lost one man and provided a lot of information. So much information that it allowed Lee to drive the Yankees back to the James River. Now, this is rather depressing to most Northerners. It hurt our pride. It left them with little hope. But Lincoln could see that the defeat was not complete. Instead, he noted that McClellan's army was still larger than Lee's, and they're really not that far from Richmond. But McClellan refused to attack. And so Lincoln at this point has had enough, and he orders McClellan to just leave the area, go join up with Major General John Pope, and, you know, Lincoln will deal with McClellan later, so to speak. Well, at the same time, Lee sees an opportunity, and Stonewall Jackson has just performed, you know, he's been performing very well, and so he sends Jackson to attack Pope. August 29th, he does that. Except Pope saw the rebels coming and began the second Battle of Bull Run just outside of Manassas. It ended, however, in a Confederate victory. Richmond is no longer threatened, and worse yet, the rebels are only 20 miles from Washington, D.C. Now you can see how Lincoln is starting to hit the panic button a little. And following these Southern victories, President Jefferson Davis sees the opportunity. And he knows that they're right outside Washington, D.C. And imagine what would happen to the U.S. government, the Union government, if their capital was captured by the South. So he changes into an offensive tactic strategy at this point. And McClellan reluctantly is the one sent by Lee and by Lincoln and by Pope to chase down Lee's army. Well, we have some idea how this is going to end, but on September 13th, 1862, there was a huge piece of good luck. Lee's orders for his army to attack Washington, D.C. are found. McClellan knows exactly what Lee is going to do. Lee was going to divide his army into 5 pieces, and all McClellan has to do is bite off chunk by chunk by chunk until he successfully overwhelms Lee's army. But McClellan, again, is overly cautious. He waits 4 days. He's not certain that these are real. Is this a trap set up? And while he's doing that, Lee is gathering his troops along Antietam Creek. So that leads us to September 17th. As I said, 4 days. The Battle of Antietam. This is one of the bloodiest battles, bloodiest days. The first day is one of the bloodiest days in the war. There were 6,000 dead or dying, and another 17,000 that were seriously wounded. This is huge. 23,000 men dead or wounded. Now, after the battle, Lee withdraws into Virginia, deeper into Virginia. So it's considered a Union victory. And Lincoln says to McClellan, hey, he's running. Lee is running. He's backing off. Go get them. But McClellan refuses to pursue. And at this point, Lincoln has had enough. He is officially removed from his position and replaced by General Ambrose Burnside. I'll give you a few minutes to chuckle about the sideburns, and usually that's how my students remember General Burnside, but he should also be included on the Yankee leader list. So I hope that was enough time to laugh at the sideburns, and now we're going to look at some pictures from Antietam. If you look closely, you can see the dead bodies strewn out across this road up against this fence. Here's another image in which the bodies have been lined up, probably to get prepared for burial. It would have been a mass grave. I mean, the numbers are just simply too large to bury each person in their own grave. If you look carefully, you can see that a lot of the clothing and shoes and such are taken. Even at this point in the war, 1862, it's a crunch time on supplies. And so they would raid, literally, the dead bodies to get whatever they could get, whatever sort of supplies. These men no longer need their uniforms. They no longer need their shoes. This next picture is of a grave. And another one of, again, a mass grave. So Antietam had a profound effect on the war. Number one, the Army of the Potomac, even though they didn't continue on after Lee, they still had this sense of confidence that they could challenge Lee. Before that, Lee is pretty much just on a roll, and we're really concerned. Union leaders are concerned, and Union soldiers, that they can't compete against Lee. Well, that doesn't work anymore. It also marked a change in the North's goal and attitude. Why is the South still successful? And it came down to slavery. So we change our focus to end slavery as well as ending the war.